Good morning. Today we are going to solve free response question number one from the 2016 AP Physics 1 exam. Bobby, please read the problem through part AI.
Flippin' physics.
A wooden wheel of mass M consisting of a rim with spokes rolls down a ramp that makes an angle theta with the horizontal as shown. The ramp exerts a force of static friction on the wheel so that the wheel rolls without slipping. Part AI. On the diagram, draw and label the forces, not components, that act on the wheel as it rolls down the ramp, which is indicated by the dashed line. To clearly indicate at which point on the wheel each force is exerted, draw each force as a distinct arrow starting on and pointing away from the point at which the force is exerted. The lengths of the arrows need not indicate the relative magnitudes of the forces.
Thank you, Bobby. Bo, please answer this question.
Sure. The wheel has mass, so it has a force of gravity acting down on it at the wheel's center of mass. The wheel is touching the ramp, so there is a force normal acting on the wheel at the point of contact between the wheel and the incline. The direction of the normal force is perpendicular to the incline and up, therefore it points to the center of mass of the wheel. It states in the problem that there is a force of static friction on the wheel, so we know the wheel is rolling without slipping. The direction of the force of static friction has to be parallel to the ramp, so it is either up or down the incline. If there were no friction, the wheel would slide down the incline, so the static friction opposes that motion, which means the force of static friction is parallel to and up the incline and acts at the same location as the force normal, the point of contact between the wheel and the ramp.
Thank you, Bo. Now some notes about how this problem was graded by the College Board. This problem, problem number one, is worth 7 points. 2 of those points are just for getting this free body diagram correct. Yes, roughly 30% of the points from this problem come from this free body diagram or force diagram. Hopefully this helps you to understand how important free body diagrams are. Also, when drawing free body diagrams, all forces need a clear indication of where they start and their direction. If you are terrible at drawing, you can always clarify force start locations and directions using words. Billy, please read part AII and give your answer.
Absolutely. Part AII says, as the wheel rolls down the ramp, which force causes a change in the angular velocity of the wheel with respect to its center of mass? Briefly explain your reasoning. Okay, well, angular acceleration equals change in angular velocity over change in time. Therefore, change in angular velocity is caused by angular acceleration. And the rotational form of Newton's second law states that the net torque equals rotational inertia times angular acceleration, where both torque and angular acceleration are vectors. Therefore, the angular acceleration of the wheel is caused by a net torque on the wheel, so the force which causes a net torque about the center of mass of the wheel is the one which causes the change in angular velocity of the wheel. Torque equals Rf sine theta, where R is the vector which goes from the axis of rotation to the location of the force causing the torque, F is the force causing the torque, and theta is the angle between R and F. The R value for the force of gravity is 0, so the force of gravity does not cause torque on the wheel about its center of mass. Theta for the force normal is 180 degrees, and the sine of 180 degrees equals 0, so the force normal causes 0 torque about the center of mass of the wheel. So the only force causing a torque on the wheel about its center of mass is the force of static friction. So the force of static friction is the force which causes a change in angular velocity of the wheel about its center of mass.
Thank you, Billy. I'll take part B. Part B says, for this ramp angle, the force of friction exerted on the wheel is less than the maximum possible static friction force. Instead, the magnitude of the force of static friction exerted on the wheel is 40% of the magnitude of the force, or force component, directed opposite to the force of friction. Derive an expression for the linear acceleration of the wheel's center of mass in terms of m, theta, and physical constants as appropriate. Okay, the force component directed opposite to the force of friction is the component of the force of gravity which acts parallel to and down the incline, or the force of gravity parallel. This means the force of static friction equals 0.4 times the force of gravity parallel, or 0.4 times the mass of the wheel times the acceleration due to gravity times the sine of the incline angle. I do want to take a moment to point out that you should redraw your free body diagram to include the components of the force of gravity and not the force of gravity itself. However, a word of caution that your free body diagram is one of your answers, so you need to not redraw that free body diagram over your original answer. If you do so, you will lose points for your free body diagram, so please be careful of that. Now we can sum the forces in the parallel direction to solve for the acceleration of the center of the mass of the wheel in the parallel direction. Defining down the incline as positive, we get net force parallel to the incline equals force of gravity parallel minus force of static friction, which equals mass times acceleration of the center of mass of the wheel in the parallel direction, which is what we are solving for. Substituting in equations gives us mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta minus 0.4 times mass times acceleration due to gravity times sine theta equals mass times acceleration parallel. And
everybody brought mass to the party. Everybody brought mass.
Exactly. Everybody brought mass to the party. That means the acceleration of the center of mass of the wheel down the incline equals 0.6 times acceleration due to gravity times the sine of the incline angle. Another note about grading. Please make sure you understand what this line means from the scoring guideline. The expression need not be correct or consistent with the force diagram in Part A. This means you do not have to get Part A correct to get points for Part B. As long as your solution to Part B is correct, you still get the points, even if it is based off an incorrect solution to Part A. So please, always answer every question, regardless of whether or not you think the rest of your solution is correct. Also, please make sure your answer is in terms of the variables provided. In this problem, that is the mass of the wheel, the incline angle, and any physical constants. If your answer has other variables, like the coefficient of static friction in it, for example, that answer is incorrect. And you do not need to substitute in a number for the acceleration due to gravity because the acceleration due to gravity is a fundamental constant. Okay, now, Bo, could you please read all of Part C, and Bobby, please answer Part I, and Billy, please answer Part II.
Sure.
Part C. In a second experiment on the same ramp, a block of ice, also with mass m, is released from rest at the same instant the wheel is released from rest and from the same height. The block slides down the ramp with negligible friction. Part I. Which object, if either, reaches the bottom of the ramp with the greatest speed? The wheel, the block, or neither both reach the bottom with the same speed? Briefly explain your answer, reasoning in terms of forces. And Part II says, briefly explain your answer again, now reasoning in terms of energy.
All right. For Part I, the block has no force of friction acting on it. Therefore, the net force in the parallel direction on the block has a larger magnitude and therefore has a larger acceleration down the incline. A larger acceleration on the block will result in a larger speed on the block at the bottom of the incline, so the block has a larger speed at the bottom of the incline.
For Part II, both the block and the wheel start with the same amount of mechanical energy, and it is all gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential energy is converted to kinetic energy as the object goes down the ramp. The block is not rotating, therefore the block will not have any rotational kinetic energy as it slides down the incline. Therefore, the block will have more translational kinetic energy than the wheel because some of the kinetic energy of the wheel has to be rotational kinetic energy. Therefore, the block will have a larger speed at the base of the ramp.
Correct. Very nice, everybody. One last note about grading. Both CI and CII are worth 1 point and state no credit for answer without explanation. In other words, anytime a question asks you to explain your answer, you absolutely must do so. Not explaining your answer will most likely get you 0 points. And one quick final note. The College Board expects full sentences, not sentence fragments like what is currently on the screen. I used sentence fragments to make it easier to fit everything on the screen, but maybe it would have been better to write everything out instead. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.